shout of all. First and foremost, I want to give all praise, glory, and honor to you, to Yahweh, Hashem, Yahushua, Hashem, Kapodash. Double honors to the apostle, the elders, the great millstone. Never spent to the brothers teaching and preaching the truth, God, over the globe, worldwide. To the scattered, led, to the scattered throughout the four corners of the globe. To have repented and come back to the ways, Lord Yahweh, Hashem, Yahushua. To you, I give a sincere shout of all. Coming back into another lesson. That lesson gonna be based off what, you know, the element I talked about did last, you know, last night. You know what I'm saying? And I'm watching on how the Shia people, they continue to rebel more and more against you, how about Shem Al-Shah. And you know, he was going in on that lesson, you know, with, you know, talking about Charleston White. And, you know, his whole mindset, you know, saying, oh, I'm just being a wicked two-third. You know, basically, you know, he said, you know, some swelling words, you know, against Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah, you know, which, you know, then got me upset. He had me angry because of, you know, the words that he dared to speak against Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah. You know what I'm saying? Not just him, but, you know what I'm saying? You know, not, you know, words that people speak against our Lord, man. You know, have no regard, no respect, you know, unto our power. Well, you know, getting back on Charleston White, he's our apostle. You know what I'm saying? Basically, he, you know, in a nutshell, he denounced being a Hebrew. You know what I'm saying? He said he'll rather go back camping than Hebrew. You know, basically, he said he'll rather sin against Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah, you know, rather than being a Hebrew. And, you know, the Most High, Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah, that was a special judgment for that guy, man. You know what I'm saying? Because that's the mindset of a lot of these two-third Jakes out here. You know, their mindset is to speak, you know, swelling words against Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah. And the scriptures say that the Most High, he's going to laugh at you when your fear coming, man. Meaning that when you get judged about, you know, by Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah, you know what I'm saying? He's going to laugh at you, man. He ain't going to have no pity on you because of the words that you have spoken against Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah, you know, unless you repent and turn back to the Heavenly Father, for which, you know, these two-thirds, they're not going to do that because they're walking in great pride. You know, they're not going to repent. You know what I'm saying? Because of the fact that a lot of these two-thirds, they, you know what I'm saying, they have a controversy against Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah. You know what I'm saying? And Hebrews 10:31 says it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living Father. You know what I'm saying? And this guy speaking these swelling words against Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah, basically against being a Hebrew. You know, the Lord got something prepared for him, man. He got a special judgment prepared for Charleston White. And any of these, you know, two-thirds, you know what I'm saying, they agree with him. And they agree with what he's saying. You know what I'm saying? Because the fact of the matter, these people don't, you know what I'm saying, these people don't think for the two-thirds. They don't think for themselves. They go along with what this guy is saying. You know? And that's the reason why he, Hosea 4:6 comes to play, you know what I'm saying? My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. You know, our people, they had no knowledge, you know, they had no knowledge for Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah. You know what I'm saying? That reason, you know, you got these guys speaking out against, you know, being an Israelite, talking about something, you know. Yeah, he had, what have he done against the Most High for, you know, for him to get punished? You know, basically, he ain't done no wrong, but yeah, you blaspheme against the Lord, man. You know, you spoken swelling high words against Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah, but then turn around in the same breath, saying that you haven't done nothing wrong. You know, see, this reason why Zechariah 13th chapter and 8 verse will come to play that two parts of people will be cut off of God. Because they are, as the scripture said, they are the degenerate plan. You know what I'm saying? they had no mindset to repent and come back to the way they how about shit out, y'all. You know, they speak sweaty words against the Lord, man. And then they wonder why things are happening to them the way they are. Why is it happening to their family members? You know, why things come happen to them? Because you say, you know, you two-thirds, they ain't got the mindset to repent. You know, you still trying to tramp your way to see love, you know, amongst these heathen nations. And all these things that are against the Lord, man. And then you wonder why stuff is happening to you the way that it is. You know what I'm saying? And then get back to Charles White, this guy said that he stick behind Kanye West, and even Kanye West, you know, acknowledged that he's a Hebrew Israelite. Fancy that. The same thing that you said that you was against, and Kanye West pretty much, you know, admitted that he was a Hebrew Israelite. You know what I'm saying? J1A said double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. So you get that man is very unstable. You see? And, you know, at the end of the day, he probably, got paid off or whatever. But, you know, it's all for the sake of y'all about Shem Al-Shah. He really exposed the guy for what he is, man. And he really exposed a lot of these two-thirds, you know, Jason, a lot of these heathen nations as well, man. Because really, this what you're saying is really how pretty much how a lot of these two-thirds feel. You know what I'm saying? How they really feel against, you know, those who repent and come back to the ways of Yahweh, Shem HaShah. And they really hate the Lord, man. They really have a controversy against the Lord because of, you know, the way he wrote the script. You know what I'm saying? They don't like the way he wrote the script. You know what I'm saying? Two-thirds, they don't like to be a chosen people. They don't like to be set above these heathen nations. That's the reason why they said the things that they say against the Most High. And that's the reason why they say the things that they say against being an Israelite. Because they hate how the script is being written. You know what I'm saying? You even have Charles the White, you know what I'm saying? He a devil. He'd rather be a byword than to be his true heritage. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, being a nigger, you know what I'm saying? Even though the scripture has turned not niger, which would be, you know, dark skin or black. You know what I'm saying? This guy's talking about he a nigger. And then he goes into all types of people that shit had their own shoe line or whatever. You know, which is really going off. And like I said, Yahweh Shem HaShah has a special judgment for that cat, man. You know, you're not going to speak high swelling words against Yahweh Shem HaShah. And then you expect that you're going to get away with it. No, the Most High is going to require you with it, man. Yeah, people on the comic board agreeing with them and, you know what I'm saying, saying that he should be the next, you know, so-called black president because Barack Obama wasn't really there, but with Barack Obama, by the way, he's a Hamite anyway, so he's not our people, you know what I'm saying? And that was wrong with Jay, man, because they don't even think for themselves. They had this guy, like Charles White, they backed this guy up. You know what I'm saying? Because he said a thing that, you know, that these two-thirds really want to say. You know what I'm saying? And you know what I'm saying? And he has a platform. You know what I'm saying? He said these things that, and really, you keep people just really got a hatred. You know, against your own nation, man. Against your own nationality. You know, because your nationality requires for you to have order. And that's what a lot of Jays don't want. They hate order. They hate structure. You know what I'm saying? They hate discipline. And that's a lot of you Jays out there. You hate order, you hate structure, and you hate discipline. That's the reason why it's a light day for you to come up against the men of the Lord and come up against Yahweh Shemal Shah. It's a light day to you, but you can come be judged, man, by Yahweh Shemal Shah. Because you people not gonna get off of the move, you know what I'm saying? The words you're saying against the Lord, you think you're gonna get away, you think you're gonna get off. They think the Most High is not gonna fire you of that. Guess what? He's going to require you of your house for the words you spoke against me. And don't think for a second that the head of father ain't how about your mouth shine, you know what I'm saying, ain't recording all this. You know what I'm saying? And scripture said that the eyes of how about your mouth shine, it's locked in how about your mouth shine, is 10,000 times right now. You know, he has an angel going back and forth, recording every day and reporting to y'all by the Shemal Shah. So you people think that what you're saying, that you're going to get away with it. You know what I'm saying? You're not going to get away with it. And the reason why you just feel like that, like I said earlier, because you hate how the script is being written by Yahweh Shemal Shah. You hate that we had to wake up to the truth according to Ezekiel 37 chapter, you know, Revelation 11:11, you know what I'm saying? The elect has repented, come back to ways Yahweh Shemal Shah. You know what I'm saying? And the truth is right before your very eyes, man. And prophecies come to pass right before your very eyes. And you people hate what's going on. That's why you had no bones to speak against the truth. You know what I'm saying? Scripture say you can't do nothing against the truth before the truth. You know what I'm saying? End of the day, you know, Charleston White may do all these things and say all these sweater words against being an Israelite away or not. And speak these sweater words against your high by Shemal Shah. But at the end of the day, you ain't doing nothing but drawing more people into the truth. You know what I'm saying? And also you mocking yourself. You know what I'm saying? And this guy, more likely, you know, just speaking as a man, he probably made, you know, covenant, you know, with the J's, man. You know, I could be wrong, but, you know what I'm saying, you can't never tell with these people. You know, because, you know, Jay believed that, he made that covenant with hell and death, and you know, in agreement, according to Isaiah, the 28th chapter, the 10th and the 13th verse, you know, you must be correct on it. You know, because Jake has the mindset, you know what I'm saying, to make covenant with these heathen, make covenant with death and hell. All they agree mean that, you know, they think that because they made a covenant, you know, with Esau, he made covenant with these heathen nations, they believe that they're going to get away. Guess what? You're not going to get away because scripture 1 Peter 4:17, the judgment will start first at the house of Yahweh Shemal Shah, which you Israelites, you so-called Black Latino Native Americans, you're gonna get judged first. You know what I'm saying? Because you give the law, statute, and commandments. You got this guy, you know, guy Charles White that's speaking these things against the Lord, and like I say, he think he's gonna get away with it. He's not gonna get away with it. You know what I'm saying? He heard about the Hebrew Israelites. That's the reason why he said what he said. Because Hebrews 4:12 said that the word is quick and powerful and sharpening any two-edged sword. You know, this word is cutting these people, man, particularly these two-thirds. That's the reason why they speaking up against the scriptures. They speaking out against the scriptures. You know what I'm saying? They saying things against the men of the Lord. They saying things against Yahweh Shemal Shah, which is all good, though, because at the end of the day, the Lord is going to require that from you, you know, unless you repent, which, you know, they ain't going to repent. They're going to continue to do wicked. They're going to continue to, you know what I'm saying? They're going to continue to support this God. You know what I'm saying? They're going to continue to, you know, beat them up and all this stuff. And all that is for your destruction, man. You know, all this is all that for your detriment. You know, you're not going to get away with it, man. You're really not going to get away with it. You have a problem with how about Shimmy Hot Shop. You have a problem with how the script is being made, but the script is being made for your benefit. You know what I'm saying? It made for you to repent. And you have a chance of salvation, because salvation is only given to the Israelites. But you got these people like Charleston White and all these people on his coming board, man. They reject the words of the Lord, man. You know, it said in Hosea 4:6, because I have rejected the knowledge, I will also reject thee and forget thy children, meaning that the Most High have rejected them. And these people are hurt, you know. And all the heathen nations, 2/3 of our people are hurt because they're rejected by the Lord, man. That's the reason why they ain't got a problem speaking things against y'all about Shem HaShem. They hate the words of the Heavenly Father, man. They hate the words of the Lord. And they have a problem with, you know what I'm saying, being an Israelite. Because being an Israelite, you know, it makes them amongst these heathen nations. And like the scripture said, they try to why trim thy way to see love. I mean, why trying to basically see love upon these heathen nations? These heathen nations will never ever accept you, man. Because therefore you are different. You know what I'm saying? We Most High separate us from these heathen nations. You know, Yahweh Shem HaShah require us to have a standard, man. And our people, they hate the Lord. They hate Yahweh Shem HaShah. That's why they had no problem speaking against the Lord, man. They want to separate themselves from being a Israelite. But guess what? You can't separate yourself from your nationality. That's Charleston White trying to do. He's trying to say that he ain't an Israelite. He ain't a Hebrew Israelite. He's trying to hide himself, you know, saying that he's a nigger. Which at the end of the day, you call yourself a byword. You think you ain't an Israelite, but guess what? And Yahweh Shem HaShah puts you as an Israelite. That's what you is. You're an Israelite at the end of the day. You're a Hebrew Israelite. There ain't nothing that you can do about it. You can try and denounce it all you want. But you gonna have to come to terms that you're a Hebrew Israelite. And then in that same way, a lot of you 2/3 out there, you gonna have to come to terms that you're an Israelite. And there's nothing that you can say. He even changed it. Why you chase out there, y'all hate the words of the Lord. You know what I'm saying? You over trim your way to try to see love and try to denounce yourself from being an Israelite, but at the end of the day, boy, you still an Israelite. At the end of the day, these heathen nations still gonna hate you, no matter what you do. You can go out here and make all the videos on why you denounce being a Hebrew Israelite. But at the end of the day, these heathen nations will still hate you. You will still never be accepted of them. And Jay can't come to Jay don't want to come to terms with that. That's the reason why they out here, you know, trying to find ways to, you know, disregard the words of Yahweh Shem HaShah. He even had Charleston White said one particular time that the scriptures are the so-called white man bull, which the scriptures. Brother already did a lesson on the scripture condemned the so-called white man. So how in the world is it his book and the scripture condemned the so-called white man? You see, you people trying to find an excuse or not to accept the words of Yahweh Shem HaShah, but that's okay though. At the end of the day, you're going to be slain before the Most High. Because scripture says in Luke 19:27, those that are my enemies, that I should not reign over them, bring them hither and slay them slay them before me. You know what I'm saying? You're going to get slain before Yahweh Shem HaShah. you too there, you hate the words of the Lord. You don't want your house shall rain over you. And then why some of you gonna get slain before Yahweh Shah. You know what I'm saying? Because you hate the Lord, man. And the Most High is gonna require that of you. And those who, you know, support Charles and White, you backing them up and all this stuff, and you think that you wanna get away with it, you think that you want to get by, you think that just because you're trying to love these people, you think the Lord not gonna get you for that? The Lord is gonna require that of you, man. So no matter what you do, the Lord gonna require that of you. He gonna make you pay for that. You know, especially you speaking swelling words against him. But yeah, these two-thirds, man, they had that mindset of, what Charles the White was saying. You know what I'm saying? That's how they really feel. But you know, he just went out and came out and said, but this is really how the two-thirds actually feel in their mind. You know what I'm saying? They hate the words of the Lord. That's really why they're doing everything trying to not denounce being an Israelite. You know what I'm saying? And the scriptures got these people upset. You know what I'm saying? The words of the Lord is piercing them, man. That's really why they're speaking out against the words of the Lord. You know, you got people like Charles the White speaking out against the words of the Lord. And you had these celebrities. You know what I'm saying? They trying to find ways not to associate themselves with being an Israelite. You know what I'm saying? They don't want to let this world go. And that's what it's really all about. Because two-thirds, they love this world, man. Particularly among these celebrities. They don't want to give up their fame and their riches and everything else. When you're all about to shoot out shot, they hate the words of the Lord because the world. When you're all about to shoot out shot, you know what I'm saying? Makes them look at their own life and look at how wretched their life feels. That means why they hate the words of the Lord. You know what I'm saying? They don't want the gospel being preached. Because why? Because they love this present life. You know what I'm saying? Just like the scripture said, you know, Paul said, demons have forsaken him, loving this present world. That's a lot of these jakes out here, man. They love it. They love this prison world. They love this rulership. They have no problem speaking out against being an Israelite. But, you know, Charles White ain't got the energy towards his oppression. He can speak out against the Israelite and his own people when it comes down to his oppression. He ain't got nothing to say. You know what I'm saying? His oppression sent back to prison and all that stuff. He has nothing to say. Then he ain't got a problem speaking against the Lord, talking about something. But he went back 2,000 years ago and all this and all that. Talking about something. He ain't did nothing against the Lord for the Lord to be mad at him. Yes, you did. You were one of the same spirits that back 2,000 years ago was in the crowd, basically, you know, chanting out a crucified Savior, man. You know, crucify your house shot. You know what I'm saying? You probably one of the spirits, but you know, it is what it is. You know, you really hate the Lord, man. You really hate your house shot. And every why y'all when your house shot comes back, man, he gonna judge you, man. You know, because you ain't getting by what you did. Crucified, and then you turn around and said, let the blood be upon us and our children. You're going to have to pay for that. You're going to have to pay for it for that act, what you did. That means why you hate your house shop. And that means why you hate what you stand for. You hate the men of the Lord. You hate those, you know what I'm saying, who basically trying their best to live for Yahweh Shah, y'all had no problem speaking against them, man. But guess what? At the end of the day, y'all about Shem Al Shah, he's gonna fire that from all of you, man. You know, typically you Israelite, that reason why you two-thirds, you gotta go, man. You have to go. And you two-thirds ain't going fast enough, man. Because you hate the words of the Lord. You hate Yahweh Shem Al Shah. You hate what he stands for and what he stood for. That reason why you can't even come to terms with being an Israelite. You hate being an Israelite because being an Israelite requires order. It requires, you have a structure, you know what I'm saying? And Jace hate order and discipline and structure. They hate it. They want to be like the heathen nation. They want to run and serve their gods and stuff like that. Why? Because they gods, you know, these heathen gods don't require anything of them. They could be the biggest demon in the world. And that's what Jay want. They want to be their own man. They want to be their own, have their own mindset, because the scripture tell us, you know, that we ain't got our own free will, man. We don't have our own free will. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? We, you know what I'm saying? Either way it goes, you're doing the will of Yahweh by Shem Al Shah, then that was, you know, doing being righteous or wicked. But, you know, that's the will of Yahweh by Shem Al Shah. You can't escape the hand of the Lord, man. Okay. No matter what you do, you're still doing the will of Yahweh Shem Al Shah. You know, that means why Revelation 22nd chapter 11 verse said that he that is filthy, let him be filthy still. You know, he that is just, let him be unjust still. You know, he that is righteous, let him be righteous still. And he that is holy, let him be holy still. You know, roughly paraphrasing. You know what I'm saying? If you have a filthy mindset, you want to be filthy. You know what I'm saying? And then you got to get Charles the White has all these followers and people beating him up and all that. What did Yahweh Shah say? He said, leave him alone. You know, let the blind lead for the blind, and they both should fall into a ditch. And you people that have something against Yahweh Shah, Shem Al Shah, and you beating this guy up, you know what I'm saying? You following them. Person that is blind, and both y'all are gonna fall into the ditch. Both of y'all are gonna be judged by Yahweh by Shem Al Shah. You know what I'm saying? You ain't gonna get away with what you're doing and what you said. You know, the Most High will require that from you. You see? And listen, what that guy was saying last night in the live stream, man, it got me upset. You know what I'm saying? He had me pretty pissed and upset. I'm like, wow, really? You had no regard for Yahweh Shem Al Shah? You ain't in fear of Yahweh Shem Al Shah? What you can do? Really? But hey, you know, that's your lot, man. That's the lot that Yahweh Shem Al Shah chose for you. A lot of you people gonna be destroyed, man. Particularly you two-thirds. You're definitely gonna be destroyed. And if we don't repent, which, like I said, a lot of them not gonna repent. Because they feel as though that they have not done anything wrong. So when you got a person with that mindset, feel as though that they ain't done anything wrong, they're not gonna repent. They're gonna say, I ain't done nothing wrong. They have no accountability. Charles White ain't gonna repent. I don't see him repent. If he does, then I'll be first to admit that I'm wrong. But I don't see that guy repent, man. I really don't, because he one of them guys that don't take accountability for anything. You see, he done wrong his dad and father. He ain't gonna take accountability. Cause he walking in pride, just like a lot of these two-thirds is. Just like a lot of these heathen nations, they walk in pride. They had no fear of Yahweh Shem Al Shah. The reason why they're doing stuff and saying things that are against the Heavenly Father. And they don't think that they're gonna pay for it. brought down low. You know, because pride is go before destruction, the heart is speak before a fall. You know, if you walking around in pride, man, you gonna be abased. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna be brought to a lower state. You know, just as Esau, you're gonna be brought to a lower state. You know, he walked in great pride. And so are you two-thirds, man. You're gonna be brought to a lower state. You're gonna get humble real quick. And all the words that they got saying, we're gonna see what them feet that you roll in on you, man. See how proud, proud you are when the feet that you roll in on you. And you're gonna be crying and begging that you know what I'm saying, you on their side. And guess what, Jay? These female troops and these UN troops, they ain't gonna give a damn about you. No, they gonna round you up or they gonna kill you. They gonna get rid of you because that's what Yahweh Shem HaShem wants. He don't want them, he want them female troops and the UN troops to get rid of you. Some of you gonna be casting them. As it said in Revelation 6 chapter 10 verse. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna be cast in a prison. You know, a lot of you Jays out there, you're gonna be cast in a prison. They say you're gonna be cast in a concentration camp. Particularly those who, you know, you have those swelling words against your high five shit mouth shot. You really gonna pay for what you're saying. Walk around in great pride and not repent and not seeking the face of Yahweh Shem HaShem. You know, your ass gonna be destroyed, man. Your chance of life gonna be destroyed if you don't repent, which I said earlier, he ain't gonna repent. Because he oozing with pride. You know what I'm saying? And like him, you people got a problem with the Israelites, man. Y'all got a serious problem with the Israelites. You know what I'm saying? Particularly, you know, you two-thirds, man, y'all don't want to be your nationality. Forget what, at the end of the day, you a Hebrew Israelite, whether you accept it or not. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, these heathen, you know what I'm saying? These heathen, they don't care about you. You know, these heathen are the ones that, you know what I'm saying, they conspired against you. You read Psalms 81st chapter, first through like the 8th to 9th verse. You know what I'm saying? All these heathen hate you, man. And you two-thirds don't want to be Hebrew Israelite, but you want to trim your way to see love among these heathen nations that hate you. You know what I'm saying? They don't even love you like that. They don't even consider you. You know what I'm saying? These heathen nations ain't never come to you, so-called black Latino Native Americans, and ask you about your well-being or your welfare. They don't give a damn. They don't give a damn about your well-being. But you got a simple mind, and Jay got up talking crap against you. How about Shem HaShem? And then they think. You know, they think that they gonna get away with it. They think that the heathen nation gonna love them after they denounce they nationality. These heathen nation still gonna hate you. And particularly Esau, he definitely hates your God. He definitely hates you. Yeah, you got Jake out there trimming away to see love, man. You know what I'm saying? Charles White is one of them wicked men. That said in 1 Maccabees 1:11, you know, said it, you know, came past those days, you know, rough paraphrase, that they came out of years of wicked men, said, let them make covenant with the heathen nations. You know, since we departed, we had more sorrow. That's the mindset of a Charles White. That's the mindset of a Charles Barkley, Shaquille O'Neal, Reggie Miller, you know, all these wicked ass Jays, man. Let them make covenant with the heathen, man. Once we depart from them, we depart from them, man, we've been going through hell. Let them make covenant with them. crazy things even for them. You know, that's the mindset of these people. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, they think that, oh, we can do what we want and nothing's going to happen to us. Guess what? Y'all by Shema Abshah allow these things to happen to you. You know, you ain't getting away. No matter how you try to look at it, you're not getting away from y'all by Shema Abshah. He's going to require that from you. You hate the words of Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah. You hate the words of the Lord. You know what I'm saying? You're not going to get away with it. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, you're going to lose. You are going to lose. You're going to lose big time. You see? You're not going to get away from the Heavenly Father, man. Because he controls you, man. You ain't got no free will. And he wants you to, he wants Charles White to say those high sweater words. So that way, when he get judged, then he's going to be a righteous judgment. You know what I'm saying? People don't understand the mindset of the Heavenly Father. You know, you speaking sweater words against them, and you don't think that you're going to have to pay for that. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, I see people talking about you 230, you ain't got no fear of Yahweh Shema Al-Shah. We ain't worried about these heathen nations because Most High ain't dealing with them. But he constantly had you 230, you know, calling you 230 to repentance. Having the men out there on the highway, byway teaching you, you got a problem with them. You had a problem with your Al-Shah. Yeah, well, that's okay though. The Lord gonna require that from you. You're gonna pay for that. You're gonna pay for that deal. You know, and that's it for a lesson. You know, wanna give all praise, glory, and honor to unto Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah, by Sharon Confidence, ever honor to the apostle Ellis from Great Bellstone. Shalom to the hopeful elect. Shalom.